The History of Odious Debt. Our story starts in the 1920s with Alexander Sack. Sack was a minister and law expert in Tsarist Russia. After the 1917 revolution, he taught in the universities of Europe and the USA. In 1927, he came up with a brilliant concept, the concept of odious debt. In order to define a debt as odious, three prerequisites are needed. 1. The government of the country receives a loan without the knowledge and approval of the people. 2. The loan is spent on activities not beneficial to the people. 3. The lenders know of this situation, but play possum. Sack's proposals sound progressive, even revolutionary. Actually, at the time, they served the interests of a rising superpower, the United States of America. The USA had found themselves in need of the odious debt concept in 1898, when they won the Spanish-American War and annexed Cuba. Their problem was, together with Cuba, they acquired the debt incurred by the Spanish colonial regime. And since that debt lasted four centuries, from 1492, when Columbus set foot in America, till 1898, that debt was quite heavy. Of course, the USA had no intention of paying for the mistakes of past regimes. They decided that Cuba's debt was odious and simply refused to pay it. The same had happened in Mexico a few decades earlier. When the Republicans overthrew Emperor Maximilian I, they had decided that the debt he had incurred was odious. Maximilian had borrowed huge sums of money and excessively high interest rates to deal with the uprising against him. And since he owed a lot, mainly to the people of Mexico, he was sentenced to death and sent to the firing squad. In the late 19th, early 20th century, most instances of odious debt concerned underdeveloped countries on the American continent. Actually, a rising superpower was involved in all those debt repudiations, the United States of America. And this same superpower brought the concept of odious debt into the 21st century.